blasting to reduce rock to rubble, the subsequent removal of said rubble by 18 mules for many weeks, often times occurring 7 days a week, until all that remained was enough to provide a level base for construction. With Dowling Village adequate year capacity, the residents of Rockcliff Farm endured countless calls of assistance to electrical or appliances or plumbing or doors. Additionally, there's a Firestone store up here, and in the summertime they operate, their doors open, and with the air drills, the hammer drills, whatever you call them, we listen to the buzz as they change and sell tires. We also do a lot of radios year-round, traveling to and from Dowling Village. All of these are inconvenient, but none of them are deal breakers. Dowling Village is a good name. I also want to be clear, the developer of Dowling Village has been respectful of our concerns in trying to resolve them, and it is our anticipation that will continue. Since a formal development plan has not been provided, we request an additional public hearing when the formal development plan becomes available for review. We'd also like a traffic study. We'll only talk about Route 146 tonight, the Erie Valley Highway. The whole list pushed is already short. You've got people down the street here who are looking to put up a gate so people don't use that very street for short. But we'd just like some kind of assurance that we don't start to suffer the same consequences. And on behalf of the residents of Rockville Farm, I would propose the following stipulations be approved and included in consideration of the zone change being considered for the 322 application. I'm not sure after what I hear this evening that these requests belong here. Maybe they belong in another here, but if you bear me up, the construction stipulations, we would like to regarding construction and land preparation, due to the proximity, and they are right on the border. We've got one building that's probably no more than 10 feet property. 322 real property. So due to the proximity to Rockcliff Farm, in anticipation of the blasting that will occur during construction phase, we request a video recording of all Rockcliff Farm property, including roadways, parking areas, concrete pads, garage floors, and interior walls. That blast could be limited to 2 on a scale of 10, on a scale of 1 to 10 of blasting force. The reason I say 2 is because when they were blasting in bags, different days they'd say, you thought you had to pull 1-3 bags. So I went back and I spoke to the folks, and they said the scale is from 1 to 10, they never exceeded 2, so we'd like to see that maintained. The other thing is they used to blast, and we didn't know they were going to blast. So when they were blast, they wouldn't notify anybody. You'd be sitting right in the back next to you, 200 feet away, there would be an explosion. So we spoke to the developer, he agreed, he set up a system that they would call anybody that wanted to be notified 15 minutes before the blast would occur, you'd get a phone call. So at least you knew what was coming. We also requested the blasting occur only Monday through Friday, no holidays, between the hours of 8 a.m. and 4:30 p.m. Also, the removal of rock, soil, and construction debris should also occur only on Monday through Friday, no holidays, between the hours of 8 and 4:30 p.m. The grading of the property shall occur only Monday through Friday, no holidays, before 8:30 p.m. He got kind of, his construction got kind of messed up, and there were all kinds of construction put right 7 days a week there for a while. I understand why I have to do it. If it can be avoided, that would be good. There's going to be some tree and shrub removal. That also should occur only Monday through Friday between the hours of 8 and 4:30 p.m. Also, building construction. Lighting, we would like to see that the lighting does not encroach onto Rockwood Farm. And landscaping, we asked that we put an 8-foot black chain link fence for security purposes and a 60-foot deep buffer of arborvitae no less than 8 feet in height along the whole border of Rockcliff Farm Association's proposed development. And the reason for the fence, I don't know if you folks ever look at it, if you go to Walmart and look at it, they've got a black chain link fence. If you look over, there's a ton of trash there. I don't know how it gets there, but it looks horrible. We just don't like the same thing happening to our property. Now, the description of the business highways is stated to establish and provide areas for commercial establishments that depend primarily on a great volume of vehicular traffic. Typically, uses include those which offer accommodations and services to motorists, specialized retail outlets, and commercial enterprises. Regarding we ask that the following stipulation be included should you choose to approve this application. No drive-through or drive-in restaurants shall be allowed. Hours of operation shall be no earlier than 6 a.m. and no later than 11 p.m. Landscape and property maintenance shall appear Monday through Friday, no holidays between the hours of 8 a.m. and 4:30 p.m., excluding snow radiation. Sale of gasoline, diesel, or other fuels, lubricants, motor vehicles, accessories, service stations, and vehicle sales, major and minor repair of vehicles, retail activities from tents and other temporary structures.
I'm sorry, sir. Could you just slow down a bit? Retail activities, repair of vehicle, retail activities.
From tents and other temporary structures shall be prohibited. Dumpsters shall be contained in at least 6 foot surround and shall be empty only between the hours of 8 a.m. and 6 p.m. Commercial entertainment enterprises shall be constrained to the inside of the enterprise building. We would like to reserve the opportunity to alter or amend these stipulations upon receipt of a form of development statement. Basically, what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to preserve the quality of life for the residents of my farm. I know you guys have a job to do, and if that's up to you, business side, I would just like to make sure that we continue to live the way we do. Thank you. Take any questions?
Do you have any interest in being on the planning board?
I can't, sir, sorry. I trust the outstanding hiring, so I'm through that concern.
Like I said, I think those are all good points, but like I said, like Gary said, we've got good people in planning boards and just come and say that. We did the same for Anchor Subaru, trying to give them buffers, trying to point the light certain ways, and I think that's all great. That's not really up to us. We just want to zone it one way or the other.
Well, then let me ask the question then. Well, we have another opportunity. When that formal plan is presented, if you guys pass the zoning for tonight, we the residents, we have an opportunity for another hearing, or can you get the people in?
Mr. Rosen, well, if it's it depends on what mechanism that they apply under. If they apply under a master plan, then there's a public hearing that's mandated.
Okay.
If it's development plan review, then it won't be a public hearing, it'll be a public meeting. And the difference is a public hearing is mandated under the master plan process.
But not under do we have an opportunity for just?
Yes, the planning board will give you that opportunity. It's just the difference between a public hearing. You'd have to pay attention to what's being advertised on the Secretary of State instead of getting a direct notice. Like you receive a direct notice here.
Correct.
So that's the difference.
So they don't have to advertise?
No, they'll advertise, but it will be on the Secretary of State's website. It won't be a direct notice to everybody in Rockland Farms as this was. If they go that, I don't know. It's impossible to know what mechanism they're going to apply. If they technically comply with all the regulations as they exist on the business highway, the public hearing process will definitely be minimal, if at all. Public hearing.
I served on a zoning board once on it for 5 years. People would come before us and they would request stipulations such as I have done. Well, do we have that opportunity or do we give them that away tonight?
You're not giving them away, but you're asking me to anticipate what has not been filed with the town. I don't know what's filed. If I knew that they were going to stipulate that they'll file a master plan and go through that process, and stipulate that they'll have a public hearing no matter what they file, then the answer would be yes. But if they're not going to stipulate to that, then I don't have the answer for it. Because nothing is filed with the town but this request for zone change.
I guess it's the process, right? Thank you. I have copies. Does anybody want?
I'm sorry, Mr. Howard.
Could
you
leave
one with the clerk?
I'll take a copy. Is there anybody else that would like to be heard on this? Nobody else? How about them? We got somebody in the back.
Sure. My name is Eric Fulker, that's F-U-L-F-O-R-D. My address is 80 Hampton Road. So I live across the street, a little ways from the proposed development site. And I just kind of wanted to make my voice heard. This is my first time hearing about this. I got the notice in the mail, thought I would come and find out what was being proposed. And from everything that was said, I appreciate everyone's words, everyone's time here tonight. As a resident living in residential property near enough to the proposed development, I get a little nervous hearing about a car punch being given sight unseen to a project that we don't know. It's a, you know, it's a road that I have to turn onto every day getting to work. It's a road that that is already pretty heavily congested. And as someone who's just moving to this town, I moved here because it's a little bit more rustic than other areas in Rhode Island that still has some of that a little bit of that, you know, that old town charm. And the developments exist, and that's fine. But the idea of more development, the idea of more, unchecked businesses coming in, without a clear idea of what it would be, as a resident of North Smithfield, it just makes me a little nervous. So I just wanted to have that out there. If you have any questions for me, that's fine.
Could you repeat your name and address, please?
Sure. Eric Fulford, F-U-L-F-O-R-D. And my address is 80 Hampton Road.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
One last question. I'm sorry. Is anybody else before you come back up? Anybody else?
Question.
Mr. Allen?
Counsel, could I ask you a question?
Absolutely.
Mr. Rondo, obviously, who I've known for a long time, spent a lot of time coming up and preparing his remarks. A lot of them were very good.
Sure they are.
And I think they were brief. There was something said about a master plan there. Talk to me about that.
Sure. Well, Mr. Igliozzi was correct.
When he
told you about, depending on the nature of the use, or let's say, for instance, if you go, let's say you took the church building,
yeah,
and you could renovate the church building and make it have a use again. Mr. Pucci said, well, my intent is to raise it, but let's say that someone came along within that, then you would, if, as a matter of right, he could use it and met all of the requirements, it'd be nothing.
Right,
okay? But the master plan would be, if you are into what is called the major land development, it's a stage of review before the planning board. It's the first stage, well, it's a pre-application, but it's the first real stage. It's an informational, most cities and towns have informational meetings. It's not a required public hearing, but it gives you a conceptual approval. So you look at what is proposed, and if the concept seems good, it's before all the real engineering is done. Then the next stage is preliminary, and then final.
Suppose that were the motion.
Well, I would suggest, if it's a question of notice, that there be stipulations that regardless of what use goes in, and if there's any requirement that Mr. Pelluccia, or any entity under which he's operating under, is going to be doing development on 322, then regardless of, let's say, if simple land development, if there's only an advertisement in the paper, he will give notice to the abutters as would be required, the same as required for this meeting tonight. To put us into a master plan may actually, it may not be required. In other words, you're going to get the same thing happening. Even without the master plan, if these people are notified for any land development, they're going to be able to appear in the planning board, I'm sure, even though it's not quote-unquote a public hearing, they're going to take input.
So to summarize, I would be more than happy to give notice to Mr. Rondo as president of the association in light of any direction that as a good neighbor. I mean, obviously we need to work with the neighbors and the people around, so I'd be more than happy to concede, however you want to do it, that we provide notification even when we're not required.
Right. question.
More of a statement, Mr. Faulkner. Eric?
Yeah.
Am I pronouncing your last name correctly?
Faulkner.
I'm sorry, Faulkner. Think of the airport, Faulkner. I live off Hayden Road as well.
Okay.
And I've seen a huge increase in traffic. My concern about this development is safety, is traffic. We've already had a failed system in Clark Square. Traffic, no matter the ingress or egress, whether it comes as, we're not sure yet, we don't know what's being proposed. We don't know if it's proposed to have an ingress egress through Taco Bell. If it did, people can take a right-hand turn, go into that crossover to Hayden Road, and go to other areas, other cities, communities in town. They'll also use Hayden Road as an access point to get there. To Mr. Rondo's concern, if they do come out and they take a right, many of the traffic, once they understand the traffic flow, may take your road to take the traffic light to head south, to take the turn around there. My concern has always been traffic and safety. It's already failed in that area. Now, as far as the professional service, I'm not so much hung up on that. I'd really want to know what's coming so we can have some idea of how much traffic is going to inject into the neighborhoods.
And kind of on that point, Hanson Road, to get onto to my road, coming up 146A, there's a little left turn inlet.
Yes.
And if traffic is being vented, if there's a lot of new traffic vented, taking a right, which they have to out of that Dowling Village, not out of Dowling Village light, but out of the other end, exit from the church.
Sure.
So if that is the egress, then people will be taking right, and if they want to get south again, they're going to swing a U-E probably at my...
Which they do already.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. So it'll be more people doing that and presenting more of an issue there. So that's another one of my concerns.
By the way, just I know you're not hung up on the professional services, which is good, I guess, but and you know, if you look at the use table, professional services to a large degree are allowed in the business side of that.
Okay, I don't have the zoning use table with me. What I have is a comprehensive plan, because that was, I had a sheet of paper that was quoting comprehensive reasoning, and that's why I brought it down.
Mr. Kravitz, do you want to make
I just wanted to clarify the process, potentially the Subdivision and Alien Act, the definitions, defines minor land developments. All non-residential land development projects are considered major land development plans. So that different project label was called.
That's the change.
Yeah, so they're gonna file at some point a major land development. So you'll have pre-application, you'll have master plan, preliminary application, and final. A master plan, you do the you send out the notice for an informational meeting, and then again at preliminary level public hearing. So.
And I could add to that too, that when it comes to those stages, those approval stages, you will see the checklists for submission. The things that are required, the major, are very, very detailed and deal with all of the things that the condo president talked about, and then some, as far as what is required to be submitted with the plans. You'll find if you look at them that they're very, very detailed. That's why, as a matter of fact, that's why in a major, you have the master and then the preliminary, because the preliminary is where all the big money is spent and the engineering is done. So they don't require people to do that until they get a conceptual plan first at the master level. But the amount of information that has to be submitted is considerable.
Okay, is there anybody else in the audience that would like to get up to speak on this issue? Any more questions from the council?
Make a motion, Mr. President.
Okay, I will entertain a motion to change the current zoning designation at Plat 13, Plat 70, known as 322 Eddie Dowling Highway, for professional services to business highway. I will entertain that motion at this time.
Mr. President, I just want to make a point of order. The clerk just called me here. Phil, did you formally close the public hearing first?
Okay, I appreciate
that.
That
motion should go first, and then your motion doesn't have.
I apologize. Is there a motion to close the public hearing at this time?
I'll make that motion, Mr. President.
Is there a second? Second. Now, roll call, please.
Mr. Halloran?
Yes.
Mr. McGee?
Yes.
Mrs. O'Hara?
Yes.
Mr. Zielinski?
Yes.
Mr. Bierkai?
Yes.
Pass. We have no close. And I have a
want me to read the motion again?
Okay. So, I will now entertain a motion to change the current zoning designation at flat 13, lot 70, known as 322 Botany Belling Highway, from professional services to business highway. And I will entertain a motion. Is there a motion?
I make that motion, Mr. President.
Is there a second?
Second.
Any further discussion at this time?
Mr. President, for the discussion, hold up, I may.
Yes.
If the motion's gonna be positive, which is pending, it requires a finding of consistency of consistency with the comprehensive plan by the council.
Consistency.
Or inconsistency.
Yeah.
The other. If you're gonna approve it, it requires a positive finding of consistency. You can adopt the planning board's findings.
Right, we'll adopt the.
You do that.
We'll adopt the planning board's finding, and a letter dated January 23rd, 2017. The planner, Thomas Kravitz, the counselor, please know that on January 19th, 2017, the planning board acted unanimously in support of a zone change from professional services, PS, to building highway, BH, for the above referenced property, and forward this opinion to the town council. This finding, which includes consistency with the comprehensive plan and zoning ordinances, are included for you here, along with supporting documents related to the requested following pages.
Now, I don't, Mr. Zelinski, want any further discussion on this?
Well, the council's going to vote. I'm just very uncomfortable with voting to change the zone without knowing what the proposal actually is. There's been a motion, there's been a second. Has it seconded yet?
Yeah.
Okay.
And I have to believe in the planning board, like what our administrator said too, that we have to believe in a system. So, like I said, I would think that it would go well for Congress Association as well, making sure everything's good, just like we did for the other places. You know, so I felt good about that one. It turned out all right. I'm sure it will on this one if it goes that way.
Okay. Anyone else?
One question.
Okay, roll call, please.
Mr. Halloran.
Yes.
Mr. McGee.
Yes.
Mrs. O'Hara.
No.
Mr. Zelinski.
No.
Mr. Gerhardt.
Yes. Motion passes.
The President, take it.
At this time, 5 minutes. Halloran requesting a 5 minute.